Early explorers saw Venezuela's Orinoco River as a route to El Dorado, the fabled city of Indian gold. Sir Walter Raleigh was one of the first. In 1595, he and his crew made it through the delta and 800 kilometers upriver before a series of rapids halted their progress. These turbulent waters are full of oxygen, attracting vast shoals of fish. They in turn draw in scores of hungry predators. Neotropical cormorants arrive early each morning, ready for a full day's fishing. Spectacled caimans gather in the shallows. There's a strict hierarchy, and each has a regular spot on the riverbank. Once in position, they wait with open mouths for breakfast to come their way. Egrets and herons slot in where they can. Opportunists, ready to grab a snack. Then, a fearsome sight. Orinoco crocodiles. The largest predators in South America. They grow up to 5 meters long, and powerful tails propel them at great speed. The narrow snout cuts easily through water. This is a specialist fish eater. But in the cool morning, cold-blooded crocodiles take a while to get up to speed, leaving the go-getting cormorants to strike first. During the six-month rainy season, Los Llanos is bombarded by downpours. The water level rises by up to a meter. Huge tracts of land disappear. The rains affect every aspect of Los Llanos' animals' lives. For many, they signal a time to breed. Leafy nests, carefully constructed 3 months ago, are rotting away, leaving leathery eggs exposed at the surface. The nest builder keeps a close eye. But the mother caiman won't get involved unless she has to. After several hours of struggle, the egg's inhabitant tears free. Within minutes, more and more siblings emerge. There could be 60 eggs in this one batch. The nest is well positioned, close to the high water line. Newborn caiman have many predators. Their survival instinct tells them to head straight for water. Even here, the tiny reptiles aren't safe. Danger lurks beneath the surface too. Piranhas. Until they outgrow their predators, these caiman will always be in peril. Some don't make it this far. Crested caracaras normally scavenge carrion. But an unguarded nest is too tempting to resist. This eager caracara is in for a surprise. With its first breath, the hatchling caiman fights back. But it's no match for a bird 30 times its size. Predators will kill thousands of young caiman in the coming weeks. But thousands more will survive the onslaught.